How long has the Stockton Royal been here?
The original building was built in 1946, as I understand it. Back then it was called the Stockton Theater.
Right. And how long have you been the manager of Stockton Royal?
For about 2.5 years.
What happened to put Stockton Royal out of business?
Well, our business just fell off. So, didn't have the clientele, so we couldn't stay open.
Right. And did the opening of the new Cineplex downtown have any effect?
Not at first, no. Because we did fine after they first opened.
Well, what happened to...
Our best guess is that no one was going there until Passion of the Christ came out.
So competition kind of went through there? Or?
Well, yeah. Yeah, because no one had gone there. No one bothered to go because I think it's the parking wasn't very good. People are afraid to go downtown. And, Passion of the Christ was playing there only. So that's where they ended up going. And I guess they decided it wasn't as bad as they thought.
And why couldn't you show Passion of the Christ here?
Well, because they're showing it. We're too close to show the same films at the same time.
There's a law that dictates and nudges each other the same film, but you're too close?
Right. Yeah, the film studios won't allow that.
All right. And how was it that they were able to film first in, other than, so you couldn't show it?
They have 16 screens.
All right. And what's going to happen to the Stockton Royal after it's closed?
As far as I know, they're selling the building, the whole building, including the restaurant and everything.
Do you have any idea who's going to be buying it?
From what I understand, it's a church that's buying it. But it's not us that owns the building anyway. We were just leasing.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you know what's going to happen to the building after the church buys it? Or?
No, I don't. I don't know what they want. They were interested in they were asking me whether it would be in working order, whether they'd be able to show films when we left. So I think they may want to show a film or two, you know, but I'm not sure.
All right, thank you.
After the theater was closed in April of 2004, there were several stories printed about the Stockton Royal and the Stockton Record that summer. One article in particular was about a former employee of the theater by the name of Doug Weed, who wanted to purchase the building.
I'm interviewing Doug Weed. Doug, why were you against the idea of the theater becoming a church?
Well, this is kind of a complicated thing. I mean, first, I don't think a church belongs in the middle of a business district. There's a church just about on every side, so I mean, it's a half-century old business district. I mean, a church doesn't belong there. Second, there's artwork inside, which needed to be preserved, which I doubt the church would remotely do. And third, it's a cultural, historical landmark for everyone in Stockton, and the church wouldn't really do anything to help preserve it, and would probably have degraded it, and if not, destroyed it.
How were you going to buy the building, and what were you going to do with it after you got it?
Well, I talked to several people for donations and business partners in several states. Some of them are highly influential, which I still don't really want to name them. But I would have been able to raise the money as a nonprofit organization. I would have bought the theater and then reopened it after a small renovation period to preserve all the art for the unit. And I would have run it as a movie theater, a plastic movie theater.
Why did you fail?
The Internal Revenue Service, I didn't get a lot of the paperwork I needed done in a timely manner. And Dan Cork, who owned the building, sold it to Mr. Ken Bennett from Nevada. Basically before I could get everything in order. So basically time defeated me.
How do you feel about the destruction of the Art Deco?
Saddened. I mean, it's a one-of-a-kind, it was one-of-a-kind piece of art. I mean, I doubt you'd find it anywhere else. And it's just sad. I mean, it's a movie theater built in a time frame, you know, the 40s and Art Deco, which no one builds that anymore. And I mean, it's just a tragedy.
Thank you.
Welcome.
This is Nicholas Weed, Doug Weed's brother, who was a Stockton Royal employee for 2 years. He had the opportunity to talk to the former mayor of Stockton, Gary Podesto, about the theater.
Gary Podesto was running for state assembly, and he came to Delta College, and I had the opportunity to ask him why he allowed the city center to be built too close to other existing businesses. And he said that the Stockton Royal was going to fail anyway, that if it wasn't for another theater opening, the Holiday 8 would have put it out of business. And I told him no, that the Royal was over 3 miles away from the Holiday 8, so it was able to compete. The City Center 16 was built too close, and so the movies got taken away and given to the City Center, and it was doomed to fail because it was too close. So my opinion is that Podesto had doomed the theater because he thought it was already doomed, and he just did what he thought was best for downtown Stockton and didn't really care about anything else.
In October 2004, the sale of the building to the church group Stockton Worship Center was rejected by the Stockton Planners Commission. The building was sold later to Kent Bennett for $1.2 million. Kent Bennett remodeled the building into a small arts theater, a coffee shop, and several restaurants.
Stop to pick up a paper from my